Hello, Time Lords, Masters, Companions, and Aliens. Welcome to my latest video. I'm sorry it's took a while to do one. I've just been very busy with work lately, but yes. I really hope you enjoy the video. I am the Nerd Vault. Welcome to my channel. I hope you like the new intro. It's just something to keep me going until I can find something a bit better, but it's homemade, and you know me, I like, you know, homemade things, so, yeah, let's get straight into the video. Cool. Okay, so, yep, today in this video is going to be my classic Sonics. I'm also gonna, you know, show you the keys as well. I haven't done one of these for ages, actually. The last one I did was quite a while ago, where I had all the Sonics. So yeah, I'm basically just gonna show you all of them. I think there's at least two or three new ones since I last did a video. So without further ado, let's go. The first one we have is, of course, the Dark Energy Creations second Doctor Penlight from the War Games. This is like classed as the War Games Sonic. The battery's going as well, which is literally just a pen light, basically an ever ready pen light. Of course, the name, they didn't add the name on there for copyright reasons, but yeah, it's basic. It's basic, you know, but it's still cool, and it's a must have for a Doctor Who collector. So that's that one. Next up, we have a replica that I don't think has been in a group video before. And this is a Sonic that Pointy M Props made for me. So this isn't an RB or a Rubber Toe Replicas one. And this is actually a interesting, unique variant as well. This is the Pertwee 1 Upside Down Bullet variant. So as you can see, the bullet is upside down, where this one here should be down there. So yeah, upside down. And this is the only Pertwee Sonic where the collar does not touch the halo either. It has a nice burgundy halo as well. Has a spacer on it, so you can't see the back of the bullet. The bullet is rounded, it's not sharp, it's not pointy like the others, but yeah. Then we've got the cone with the red stripe, the spirals, the famous sort of spiral. And then as we come down to here, we've got the activation ring, and then the three black grooves. And then we go onto the handle. And we've got all the pinstriping details there. And of course, this has the infamous shear as well. No sound, obviously, but it does extend down to reveal the collar. So yeah, that's that's the alternate emitter version, so that's pretty cool. Okay, next up we have the standard Pertwee one from the Sea Devils. This one was made by RB Replicas, so as you can see, it's got a red halo, a bit more of a pointier button, no spacer on the back. But the collar is touching the halo on this one, as you can see. But the details with the pinstriping and that are basically the same, really. The shear as well. And this one does, of course, like all the others, really, extend. Then we have the Pertwee 2. Actually, Pertwee 2, so this is the last Pertwee Sonic that John had. So this is the sleek version, so this is like the fourth Doctor version, but pristine, and it has obviously Pertwee's orientations. But as you can see, we've got a nice chilly red halo with a magnet, and the screw's painted red in there as well, if you can see. It's a brass halo, only painted on the outside. The collar touches the halo as well. As you can see, the yellow pinstriping and all the other pinstriping is gone. It's just a bare silver Sonic. But it's quite sleek, and that's why I like it. So, yeah, it's pretty awesome. Nice motion on there as well. So that's the Pertwee 2. Then we've got a Roboto Replicas now. Roboto Replicas 4th. Weathered. So you can see there that the halo is screws red. It's a real magnet as well. You can see the brass coming through, the nice shine on the brass. The bullet is very pointy. This bullet is very pointy. And you can see here as well that the neck has been weathered as well. Got the collar, the activation ring has got some weathering on it as well, and we've got the three black rings. Then we've got the body of the Sonic, which is pretty much the same as Pertwee 2 really, and then the infamous shear, and then that's pretty much it. Of course the head does extend as well, as it did in, I believe, Hand of Fear and Genesis of the Daleks. So there we go, at least we get those functions. So that's the fourth Doctor's. A little sort of Easter egg funny stuff to add into it before we go on to the fifth Doctor's. We have obviously Romana's. So this is Romana's Sonic that was only literally shown for a couple of seconds, and then that was it forever. We never got it again. So it's basic, as Tom Baker calls it. Bit basic though. But then he does try and steal it, doesn't he? So yes, it's an interesting Sonic. It's an interesting Sonic. But that's Romana's. Then we've got the fifth Doctor Sonic. So we've got the nice bright red halo with the bright red magnet. The screw wasn't painted red on this one, so it stays silver. The neck is now also back to the black again, not weathered anymore. Not touching the halo either. Then we've got the collar. We've got the activation ring, which is white now completely. Then the three black rings. Then we have the body, which again is like the fourth and the Pertwee 2. And then the shear there as well. So, awesome. I quite like this Sonic actually. I think it's a unique Sonic and a good twist, you know, to the Sonic. It's a good variant, you know what I mean, to go in between all the others. So, yeah, it's cool. Next up, we have the TV movie 8th Doctor, 7 and 8th Doctor Sonic. So, as you can see, it's a red bullet, powder coated, with no magnet or spacer on the back, but this bullet is quite a longer one, considerably. It's a aluminium silver halo instead of a brass halo, and it's not painted either. The black neck is firmly in place as well, and that's not black now, it's silver. The collar as well, which I'm not going to do it on this one because the bullet is a bit loose at the moment, but I will do it on the other one. But this bit here goes in and extends in. So yeah, then we've got the X activation ring, because that obviously isn't the activation button anymore on this Sonic, but it's still there for design. The three black lines that were never painted on this one, so that's why they're not painted here, but they're still, the grooves are still there. Then we've got the button placement, where the button would be to activate the Sonic. Then we have the brass ring, and then the body. On this one we have grub screws, one there, and then a nice flat surface. So that's the TV movie version. Right there. Then we have the these two that I'm showing you now are technically actually modern era. They're not actually a classic, but they have the classic build, so that's why I put them in the video. We've got the Night of the Doctor 8th Sonic. So as you can see, this is my original one that I've had for 2 years now. This one has got a glossy bullet, which I actually prefer, with a to the matte one, which has a glossy back as well. This one is silver. Everything's the same, except there's no button placement or grub screws on this one. So this is pretty bare. But I will show you now the extended feature. So there you go. It closes to hide the neck piece, and then with a quick twist it extends back open, and there you go, voila. So that is of course the Night of the Doctor one, aka basically my second 8th Doctor Sonic. So, and then last but not least for the classic Sonics anyway, we have the War Doctor Sonic screwdriver. So, activation ring made a comeback. The three black lines are back. But we have a Fez on this one. As you can see, no legal writing, like the toys, which is good. But yeah, we have a Fez on the back now as the end cap. So that's pretty cool. And this one does, of course, light up as well. Sorry if that blinds you there as well. So yeah, I love this design as well. I think this design is fantastic, you know. So yeah, love this. So that's basically it for the classic Sonics anyway. We've got a few keys here, a few TARDIS keys, because these are like, the TARDIS keys are probably, along with the Jelly Babies, are like my favourite props for the classic. So we've got John Pertwee's TARDIS key that I display with the 3rd Doctor. This one was made from the original cast, and John Pertwee himself made designed this as well, so that's pretty cool. Got the nice intricate shapes on the front. It's got a good thickness to it, this one. It's made of pewter. And then on the back there we have the constellation of Cerberus, which is the location to Gallifrey, the Doctor's home planet. Of course, not the best constellation on this key, but this key has the best front in my opinion. I think that's such a nice one. But the back kind of lets it down a little bit. But that's the first 3rd/4th/7th and 8th TARDIS key. The second 3rd/4th/7th and 8th TARDIS key is this one, which I display with my 4th Doctor Sonic. So you can see the shapes are slightly different on this one. You can have a, if you want in-depth details, you can have a look at my actual key videos on here, because they sort of talk about them all in detail. This one has a better constellation though than the other one. It has just more pattern to it, you know what I mean? So yeah, same shape but just a different sort of way about doing it. So yeah, so that's the one I display with the 4th Doctor. This one's a little one I have for fun because it's smaller than the other ones. This one's more of probably like a pendant. But again, it's, I still love the sort of braille-like kind of way that they did it. Like, it's raised. It's quite nice. And it's It's quite thick as well for a pendant. It's quite thick, you know, you could use, it's probably the thickness of a normal key, isn't it, that? So yeah, that's the pendant. Quite shiny, that one. This is the one I, if I can get it without it being tangled. Hold on a second. Oh, we've got a tangle problem. It's too many chains, that's why. This one is what I display with the 7th and 8th Dr. Sonic screwdriver. So this is more of a more of the TV movie sort of size, to be honest. Because they all change sizes throughout the thing. But the patterns are a lot more spaced out on this one. But overall, they're the same patterns. And then the constellation on this one is similar to the second one I showed you. It's, you know, but it's got all the details in it. It's awesome. So, yep, so those are the shovel keys that I own. Love the shovel keys. If I ever become a doctor, I'm bringing back the shovel key. Then we've got the 7th Doctor's Sonic key that... Well, Sonic key, I mean, the 7th Doctor's key that only appeared, I think, in one episode. Maybe two. And that's the fan key. So I've got a few of these fan keys. This is a metal one. This came with the last shuffle key I just showed you then. That came with this one. So there you go. This is my main 7th key. This is the one I have on the chain. The other one that came with the chain originally is just a tad too big, but it's still metal, so I'm still keeping it because it's still, you know, it's still awesome. It's this one. It's just this one is a little bit too big, but the thickness is like crazy. It's so thick, but like you can see there, it's still metal, so it's still awesome. Then we've got the pendant one, which is actually a BBC licensed official thing. And I have actually seen it on the thing, on the store. But that's the pendant, so yeah. But it's still metal. And then my least favourite one is the one that I actually had first. It started me off, so that's why I can't get rid of it, because it's like, I suppose, sentimental, but it's the 3D printed key. So, yeah. I got standard corrected because when I originally reviewed the my original 8th Doctor's Sonic, not the TV movie one, I actually said that it was the 7th and 8th Doctor's Sonic screwdriver. And then I said that this was the key that they used in the movie, but then I realised it wasn't, it was the shuffle key, so... I have stand corrected. If you do watch that video, it's my second video I ever did on my channel. You don't have to comment saying you're wrong, because I already know I've been corrected. So, yeah, I know that this isn't the movie key. This was used, I think, in one episode, Silver Nemesis, maybe. Now, the back, the person who's done this has just done it based on what the shuffle key is. It's the constellation of Cerberus, five constellations, but... It's in the shape of a 7, because of the 7th Doctor. So we think it's not the constellation of Cerberus, it's just the constellation in the shape number 7, so yeah. But we don't know what is on the back of this one, because it was only used in one or two episodes, and you only saw it like that. You never saw it, you know, you never saw it like that, or you know, like that, you know, or that, or whatever. So yeah, so that's the... TARDIS key. So those are the TARDIS keys, and that's all my classic Sonics. So what's left? I mean, what more, what else do you want? I suppose I could give you, oh, I don't know, I wonder what to give you. How about I give you a bit of... My 10th Doctor. Technically 11th, actually, because it's the 11th hour version. But yeah, so there you go. Second video this has been in now, I think. The first one being its own. So there you go. This has got quite a lot of views on YouTube now, this video, so thank you very much for watching it. I hope you enjoyed it. Someone commented on my video saying, why would you ruin a rare, beautiful replica? In my eyes, I haven't... Okay, I can understand from a person's view why I've changed the paint and added screws and that and weathered the head. I can understand from that point of view why you would think that I have ruined it or wasted it, but I have another one on pre-order that is due to be coming soon. Well, he's making them at the moment. Mine should be in the second batch when he ships them out. So that one will be my Series 4. So because I have two of them, I thought to myself, well, I don't want two Series 4 props, so I might as well have an 11th Hour one, as the 11th Hour is one of my favourite variants of the 9 and 10th. Probably after the Cream Aztec, to be fair, which that review I can't wait to do. Should be sometime when I come back from my holiday. I'm going to Spain on Saturday. So, yeah. So hopefully when I come back from holiday, the Aztec will be here, so I'll be able to do that review. I can't wait for that one. So yeah, so that's why I decided to do an 11th Hour paint job on this. So that's why I did it. I never thought I was going to get this. Because I didn't buy this from Nick. This I got in a trade, number 25, with one of my friends on Instagram. So I never intended to get two. So because I have two now, that's why I decided, right, I'm going to make the most of it. I could have been nice and, you know, sold one to somebody, but... If you have two, if you're lucky enough to even get your hands on a rubber toe 10th, I've been after a 10th replica since I was a kid, since I used to message CT and he would say to me, hurry up, I've got a couple left in stock. And at the time I was saving up pocket money, so it took me a while to get what he wanted, and I finally got the money and he said, oh, sorry, you were a slow cunt. So I sold it. The last one. And I didn't mind that he sold it, because it's a business. He can't keep things for one person and not for the other. It's not fair. But it's just the fact that it's the way he spoke to me that I hated about him. So yeah, so because of that, I've always wanted one. And I settled with the one company 10th for years. And it was okay at first, because I was only 15 when it came out. So it was like, oh, okay. Work out my age from there. It came out in 2015. Well, 2014, I think it was. Christmas 2014, I think I got it. And it did me well. It did me for about five years, and I don't have it anymore because it broke. But yeah. So you can understand why I'm quite hesitant about getting rid of them. But now I'm not going to be selling it, because it's a different Sonic now. It's a different prop. It's not the Series 4 prop anymore. So, yeah. There you go. Love the 10th. If you ever get your chance, if you've ordered one, if you ever get the chance to have, you know, to get your hands on a... You know, if you've got one, if you've got a number, or if you've got a CT, or if you ever get the chance to own a... CT or a rubber toe, honestly, you're a lucky guy, because it's a very good replica. There's a few inaccuracies that I've gone over in the video, so watch the video if you haven't seen it. I'm not gonna carry on, and watch my live on Instagram as well, because I explain a lot of stuff about that Sonic on there. So if you haven't seen that, next up then, I've got two more surprises for you before I end the video. Well, three, including the one I'm just about to show you now. So, 3, 2, 1, boom. That didn't mean to happen. I kind of slammed the desk when I did that flip, so... That wasn't very good, was it? This, I think, is the first, maybe, or... I think it is the first video that the CT has actually been in since it's been upgraded by Brent. So I've got the white LED back in there now. It's green in person, but on the video it looks teal, but I can assure you it is actually green in person with this particular emitter that is a custom emitter anyway. But the cores have been upgraded as well, so there you go, you can see that there. And then obviously my awesome button, red, not so secret red button, which I think is a sonic screwdriver self-destruct button, but I could be wrong, but I'm pretty sure it is the self-destruct button, to be honest. Let's see if I can do it now. Did you hear it? Did you see it? I don't know. I'll probably try and do a decent flick at the end, but that was a little flick. I don't want to hit the table again. I'll just rest that there for now. So it's in the shop for you at least. The second surprise I'm going to do from this angle, actually. In 3, 2, 1. Okay, sorry. In 3, 2, 1. Boom. You got it from a different angle there. It is my custom Mark II, even though I messed up the surprise for the first time. So there you go. It's using a custom CT emitter because I prefer the glassy ones. The swirly ones, well, the ones Nick does anyway, are too deep. So the light can't escape through it, and it doesn't make it a bright light. Whereas this one, obviously, you can see the light there. So, and it looks nice with this particular sonic. I don't have many swirls on this one. I bought this on eBay, so I didn't really get a choice. But there's just one big swirl there, and then the rest of it is just quite bare, really. I mean, there's hardly any swirls on this, but I absolutely love the brass and the wood combination. That's why I got this Mark II, because again, like a lot of the Sonics this year, I wasn't ever intending to get this, ever. So, well, I was going to get a Mark, a custom, eventually, and it would have been the Mark II, because I don't like the other ones, because I like the brass for the heft on this one, and I think the brass and the wood just makes it look fantastic. It's just such a cool thing. But I was never intending to get one this year. I was waiting because he went out of stock on his website, so I was going to wait till next year when he brings them back to get one. But this guy was selling it on eBay, and I said, "Is there anything wrong with it?" And he said, "No." And I said, "Well, why are you selling it?" And he just said, "Oh, I'm bored. I don't want it." So I said, "Oh, okay, fair enough." So I paid him, and I said, "Right, take it off eBay. I'm paying it." And I got it. So. Thumb extension with the with this one is effortless due to the ridges. Just make it, you know, so much more easier. Capaldi style, where it's, you know, extended but the short version. And then of course close mode. Cause everybody likes a shot up like that, don't they? So yeah, we'll put that one there. The final one, I'm afraid, the battery completely died. And I haven't been able to order one. I just haven't had the time to order one. So due to that fact, you will only get to see what it looks like. You won't get to see it activated, which is a shame because it's my favourite Sonic app, you know, it's my favourite design and it's the one I'd choose, and you know, so it's a shame, but I thought I'd have to, you know, I have to throw it in the video anyway, but you won't be able to see its features, but yeah. And that is obviously, boom, the 12th Doctor Sonic screwdriver. I had to add this into my video. It looks dark blue on the camera. But it's actually, it's quite a light blue, to be honest, in real life. In person, it's, yeah. The one thing I loved about the toy were these bits here, because it's so good. If I can zoom out, actually. No, that makes the quality shit. It just makes it so good to hold, you know? I really want to activate it, but there's no batteries in there. To prove it, look. See? No have batteries. But at least you get a bird, you know, bird's eye view there. So there you go. That's basically it for my video. I hope you enjoyed. It's a long video, but you know, it's a video, guys. You know, I haven't done one for a while, and I do apologise. I have got my Arkenstone Hobbit / Lord of the Rings collection video that I need to edit and do a video of. So I will be doing that tomorrow. Even though the video has been on my phone for like at least a month now, but but I will be doing I will be editing that and doing that probably tomorrow. So yeah, please like, comment, and subscribe if you haven't already. Help the Nerd Vault out to gain subscribers. I've got 79 subscribers now. I am so happy. That's the most I've ever had. I've had three channels in my life. One when I was a kid, reviewing toy Sonic screwdrivers actually, and I only managed to get 30 subscribers on there until I closed it down. And then obviously I had one called the Doctor's Props that wasn't this one. It was one that I had before I came on Instagram, and I think I reviewed my 11th, the version 2 though, not the CT. And then for some reason I got logged out and I couldn't remember the password, annoyingly, so it wouldn't let me back in, so I had to create a new one. So and that, I had about 5 or 6 subscribers on that one, but this one, 79 subscribers, thank you so much. I really do appreciate it, and you know, all I want to do is just give you entertainment, you know. That's all I really want to do. So yeah, I really, really hope that you enjoyed these videos. Please like, comment, and subscribe for notifications for when I post and when I do new videos. We've got new Sonic videos coming. I've got an iPhone 13 Pro Max. I'm getting that. So there's that as well. I've got a few more Marvel stuff that I need to review. And I might be getting some other stuff as well soon from other franchises that I'm not going to tell you about. I'm just going to let you see them for yourself. So again, stay tuned for the next videos. Thank you so much for watching, and this of course is the Nerd's Vault signing out. Peace.